Okay, sir, and I'd like vectors to the ILS 23, please.
More than 90 minutes into the flight, there was no panic in the voice of Steve Barnes piloting plane 965 Delta Mike, a Socata TBM 700.
I somehow lost tab with center.
At one point during the flight, Boston Center lost communication with Barnes. Air traffic control in Buffalo was able to regain contact.
Everything okay up there?
Yes, sir. Everything's fine.
That would be one of Steve Barnes' last transmissions to the ground.
5,000 Mike, where you headed?
Seconds later, air traffic control attempts to contact plane 965 Delta Mike.
5,000 Mike, Stafford, descent, maintain 10,000.
There's 51 seconds of complete silence.
5,000 Mike, radar contact loss.
The fact that he's not responding after a certain point is very unusual. And that's not something that a professional pilot under instrument conditions would ever do.
Barnes' lack of communication makes ABC News aviation analyst John Nance question whether hypoxia played a factor in the Friday crash.
Had this occurred at 28,000 feet, would it be an indication to me that the possibility of hypoxia was there? The fact that this occurred 10,000 feet, if they had been hypoxic, you should be coming out of it by then.
The National Transportation Safety Board says hypoxia was the cause of a 2014 Socata TBM 700 crash that killed a Rochester couple. The Federal Aviation Administration's preliminary accident report says the aircraft crashed under unknown circumstances.
There is no clear indication of what's going on here.
John also says this yellow line, which indicates the plane's speed, indicates something was wrong with the aircraft's instruments. Usually the line looks similar to a bell curve, where this looks like a heartbeat. Dan Frazone agrees. He's the former director of flight operations for a Fortune 500 company.
It's almost impossible for that type of airplane to, I think it jumped up to like 750 knots.
The FAA and NTSB are investigating the crash. The NTSB will not travel to the scene, but the deputy director of regional operations says they are actively looking into the cause.
They're going to look at aircraft history, pilot history, experience level, weather for sure. And then the aircraft type.
Investigators say all of the wreckage has now been removed from the crash site in Pembroke. Olivia Proya, 7 Eyewitness News.